You know, the song Mean was really fun to write because as a songwriter, sometimes I really like to juxtapose a pretty dark lyric with a really happy sounding song. Like, if you actually just read the lyrics of Mean, it sounds like it's pretty heavy. It's about feeling like you can't win. No matter what you say, it's wrong. No matter what you do, stuff is blamed on you. No matter where you turn, you're turning the wrong way. And that's a horrible, defeating feeling, and a lot of us feel that way throughout our lives many times. But I wanted it to be something that was singing about something that makes you feel awful, but the song would make you feel good to sing. So that was my main goal, and it was nice. It was nice singing about something that made me feel that terrible, and then going out and playing it for sold out stadiums with people that were like, I felt that way too. Oh my God, that is terrible to feel that way, but let's sing it together and then we'll be happy. It was cool winning 2 Grammys for that song. That's another little like, okay, I'm not alone in feeling this way kind of validation or whatever, but this song is always going to be special to me because it's nice when you write something that helps you get through what you're actually going through. I wrote the song Mean about that powerless feeling you get when you're being picked on. And no matter what you say, no matter what you do, the person won't stop. This song was a reaction to a bully I had in my life, a version of a bully that I was experiencing. But, you know, I never imagined that it would go out and enter people's lives and kind of represent all the bullies that other people were dealing with too.
We are here at the lovely and historic Orpheum Theater in Los Angeles to shoot the video for Taylor's song, Mean.
This theater was built in 1925 for the vaudeville, for that period in American theater. And it was big, it was a huge and important place, but it fell into disuse about 20 years ago and someone bought it and they did it up to what's now, it's restored its former grandeur. And we saw a lot of these theaters and this one just said, it was just spoke to me as the right place to be. I love all the gold and the red and all the colors. And I showed the pictures to Taylor and she loved it too. So this is why we ended up here.
The first time that I saw these sets for the first time, I absolutely couldn't believe it.
Oh my gosh.
There are so many moments over the course of just a day that where I just look at something or see something or and I just can't believe that I get to be around people who do stuff like this.
That's great! Have you seen this?
I think my favorite setup actually ended up being the train. Her album cover is really cute and fun, and I kind of like the direction that she's going in for that. It's very vaudevillian, and it was really kind of a starting point for all of the design, actually. And then moving into the other sets was a little bit of a departure.
To be able to work with a set designer and an art director and a director who can create an entire, like, prairie tundra in a theater, and then 5 minutes later have it turned into a school bathroom, and then 5 minutes later it's a fashion runway. It really, I was just in awe.
That looks really cool, dude.
I just wanted to go up to all of them and be like, thanks for even entertaining the idea of being around me. You're so talented.
Do those look old enough? Especially this bird.
What?
Yeah, dude.
Yes.
Can we rub some mud on that? Is that yours?
I mean,
these two do not look period at all.
There are moments in video shoots where if you see a detail being overlooked, you've got to step in.
Their instruments are like so 2011, it's not funny.
I really wanted my band and I to look like we were living on the prairie in the 1930s. And, you know, one thing that happened was, you know, I see Paul's playing his brand new, beautiful, shiny Gibson guitar. And I'm like, that did not exist back then. Okay.
Yeah, we can.
There's
a music store
down the street.
We can go and buy
that. And so we had to have somebody run down the street and go to a music store and just hope that they had a shabby looking guitar. And they grunged it up and it ended up being perfect.
Can I have dirt on my face?
Yeah, sure.
I mean, I think it'd be cool to have like a...
I think it would too.
Another thing is that my band, they're like incredibly good looking people and they did not look dirty enough.
Hey, that Joseph, do you have any mud?
I mean, if it would look cool, I don't
care. Yeah, because like, I mean, their clothes have dirt on them, so why not their faces?
So we had people put dirt on their faces.
Yes, yeehaw and all that. Going to have a hootenanny. Going to play some rocking American music and in the traditional styles. And it's going to be great fun. We're going to have a lot of fun.
I'm sorry. Good.
Details. I like it.
Why you gotta be so mean?
Let's bring in the goat. How many times do you get to say that in your life?
Let's
cue the goat.
Get the goat.
Get the goat.
Bring the goat down.
I think if this video were to be a shoe-in for an award, it would definitely at this point be most goats used, you know? Because there was a goat in this video, a live goat.
We're here in the main performance setup where my whole band and I are dressed sort of Great Depression prairie chic, except without the chic. And there's a goat on the stage.
Her name was Matilda. You know, she was pretty good at standing there, just blinking, just being a goat.
The goat is awesome. And it's just sort of one of those moments where you're like, really, I'm shooting a music video and we have a goat on the stage. We have now converted to the big old city.
This is the big city setup where Taylor and the band have elevated themselves from the farmyard and now they're playing Broadway. And this is where we are. Taylor's in a sparkling, lovely dress and the band are all dressed up, new instruments. It's terrific. I can't wait to get going.
I loved the end performance scene, the big city performance scene, because just the wardrobe alone was fantastic.
This is my big old city outfit. We worked really hard to get to this level, and now we're basking in the sunshine, and we're living in the big old city, and we're performing, and we have glitter. So that's why I have this outfit on.
You know, you go to the city, you want to dress up, you know, you want to look good. And so we showered, we got the dirt off of our faces and off of our clothes, and we exchanged them for suits and hats, and I'm sure this is something, the thing.
I think the costume designers and my stylists did such a great job dressing everybody because they looked like they're from the 30s. And, you know, the top hats, and I got this swing awesome flapper dress, and getting to work that dress and like the motion, every time you move, the dress moves. It was so fun to perform like that and with an old microphone, and we had such a blast.
Thank you so much for a great day, guys. Great job. That's a wrap.
Why you gotta be so mean?
We are shooting the video for Mean today. Very excited. There's a theater. I'm gonna go into it now.
The Mean music video was something that took a while to put together because the typical process you go through when you're putting together a music video is you send the song out to all these directors and they write basically their storyline of what they'd like the video to be. And that's called a treatment. So, the treatments I got back, I got like 30 of them, and none of them for me told the story of this song. And so it occurred to me after months of thinking about this video and having it keep me up at night that what if we did the entire video in a theater? That way we could show all these different storylines, we could create set pieces that created these very distinct looking performances, and we could have all these characters, you know, struggle and then thrive. I couldn't figure out the person to direct the video based on treatments, so I wrote my own and I picked a guy who I'd always wanted to work with, and his name is Declan Whitebloom.
So the idea is really one of Taylor's, actually. This is her concept, and I think it's just great. And basically, it's like a theatrical, big theatrical production of these three different vignettes with people being mean to other people, and they all end well for the people who are in the video.
I had three characters in mind. I wanted there to be a little girl because there is such ruthless, merciless
bullying that goes on in elementary school for no apparent reason, and wanted to really show how stupid it can be. For that role, I dreamed about Joey King playing it. She's this girl who is so talented.
Okay, well, Selena Gomez and Taylor Swift are great friends. And me and Selena did a movie together called Ramona and Beezus. I think that's how she found out about me, because of Selena and because of the movie. So I think this is how it came about.
She emotes in a way that just everyone just falls in love with her when they see her on screen. So I was really hoping she wasn't busy. Put in the request to her agent, and her agent called back and said she wants to do it, but she's demanding that Taylor call because she doesn't believe that this is real, which makes her even more perfect for the role. So I call Joey, and I say, hi, this is Taylor, and she goes, really? And I go, yeah.
Oh my gosh, I was like, what? I was so excited.
I can hear that she's jumping up and down as she's talking.
Yeah, totally. I'll totally do it.
And she's got her mom on the phone and her sister on the phone.
Me and my sister Haley were so excited. Everyone was so excited.
She was like, I'm just so excited.
So excited.
I just, thank you so much.
I was so excited.
I'm just so excited to be in your music video.
It was so exciting finding out.
I've never been in a music video before.
It's so exciting. It's my first music video, and you know, it's just the best that I get to do it for her, for Taylor. I'm such a big fan, and also I couldn't have had a better time. It's just so cool.
So having her on board, I already had really good feelings about the video.
So Joey King has very graciously agreed to be in the video, as per Taylor's request. And she plays a girl who is new to a school or new to a neighborhood.
I took my chair to the lunch table to go sit with the popular girls, and we all have the same dress on, and I go over there and I'm like, hey, new friends. But then they all have pink bows on and I have a blue bow on, and then they turn me away, and then I get really sad because, like, why you gotta be so mean? And so I go and eat my lunch in the bathroom stall. Gross, right? No.
But she will have her comeuppance when, at the end, the very last bit of the video, we will see Joey in the audience watching Taylor up on stage, and then she will realize that is what she wants to do with her life.
The Chippy Cheddars girl is a character that I came up with a while ago. We all know how hard of a job that is, to stand there as cars drive by and honk at you or throw stuff at you or like make obscene gestures at you. So I had this idea of the girl who has the job where you have to stand out there in front of a diner advertising it, and the last thing you want in high school is to be just out there for everyone to take shots at. But this is her job and she's got to do it. And there's a reason for that. It's because she's saving up for college, because she knows there's somewhere better for her.
I had to like dress up as like a big, huge, glamour, like cardboard star. And then the mean people were throwing cups at me. It's always been a dream of mine to dress up as a big star, you know? Pretty cool.
And we will see her later in the next setup becoming a successful CEO because she went to college, because you always got to go to college if you want to be a success in life.
Another character that I had in mind was a character I've seen a lot in my lifetime. A guy who's not interested in the same things that other guys are interested in, therefore he gets kicked around. And I've met so many fashion designers who grew up being absolutely ostracized and bullied and made to feel like they were nothing in school because they didn't play the sports that the other guys played and they didn't talk like the other guys. So I wanted to tell that story with this boy sitting in a locker room and he's reading fashion magazine. And the other guys come in and just start absolutely hassling him and trying to take it from him. And you can just see in his eyes that he just knows someday he's gonna be somewhere better.
And Mitchell, who plays this guy, our hero, is so good at being just like understated and not making eye contact with them, and he's just blocking them out and just hoping that someday it'll get better. It's really great.
No eye contact, just blocking them out. It's a perfect call.
Thank you so much. That means a lot. Yeah.
We were over there.
He's just like nailing it.
He's awesome.
Thank you.
All right, I just want to give you a hug and say,
thank you so much.
Yeah, you nailed it.
Yeah, thank you.
Awesome.
So here we are on the runway scene. This is the second half of the teen boy, from his being, he was harassed in the lockers because he was different to the football players. Now here he is, a big success on the runway, the fashion runway, in our quirky theater-inspired world.
this is me 20 years in the future, and all the hours of painting through those harassments pays off now because, you know, I'm surrounded by beautiful women.
He is now a giant fashion designer. Why you gotta be so mean? Getting to write the treatment for this video was such an amazing experience. I never expected that if I wrote a treatment, a director would love it and want to direct the video exactly the way I'd written it.
Taylor was a dream, and I'm not just saying that. She really was. She was so lovely and so generous and so came up with such great ideas. She was a great collaborator. I'd work with her anytime.
Thank you so much, you guys. This has been so amazing. You're incredible. I'm blown away.
Taylor Swift, everybody.
Thank you. Great job.
So we had one of the coolest video shoots ever. This was just unbelievable. I'm so stoked about it. Like, I was watching some of the footage back. I can't wait to see it come together. You guys, this
That's
is crazy.
Full shot.
This is probably the coolest thing I've ever been a part of. It tells a bunch of different storylines while at the same time having performance shots that I'm so stoked about. Visually, it just goes in line with everything I've been obsessed with lately. Theaters and productions and, you know, it really tells stories that, to me, really matter. And it's also just really fun. And I couldn't be happier with the way that it turned out.